Hello everyone! In this video you are going to see me test a new resin but also some pigments I bought, and I'm using an MDF board this time of 39 centimeters, and I primed it as I always do with two layers of gesso and two layers of acrylic paint so that it's sealed in and that there will be no air coming out of the wood into my resin to prevent the air bubbles. And what I already said, I'm using a new resin from the Dutch company again, Harion Epoxy and Polyester. And I have used a resin before from this company, but I thought it was too thin. Now they sent me a sample of another resin, and this resin is much thicker than the first one I tried. This resin, the viscosity of this resin is the same as the Stone Coat Art Coat, and as you all know, I love the Stone Coat Art Coat, but Stone Coat is changing their shipping arrangements, and in the meantime they can't ship to me in the Netherlands, though, so that's why I'm searching for a backup resin to use. And that's why I'm testing this resin. I'm also going to use some pigments of Dipon .de. It's a German company that also sells resin, but also some very nice pigments. So I'm going to try two of those pigments. The first color I'm using is the Electric Blue by Lares. Very nice color, very sparkly. And what I already said, I'm going to use two pigments of Dipon, and it's the True Aluminum Gold Alloy pigment and also the Antius Color Shift Pearl pigment. And that's the color I'm using now. Very nice sparkly color. So I'm very curious how these pigments work in resin. But I'm also curious if this resin can create the same effects I can create with the Stone Coat Art Coat. And also I'm very curious how the finish looks of this resin. Yes, and I'm also using the Stone Coat White base tint, because we all know if we use that base tint, we can create cells and lacing. So I'm using the swipe technique. So I'm dragging the colors over the white base tint very slowly. And normally, with this technique, you can create the cells and the lacing. But with the white base tint, you don't need to add a lot of it in the resin, because if you add too much, then all the effects will be gone during drying. Also, not much heat is needed, because then the resin will get too thin, and also then your effects will be gone. So this will be a lot of testing of resin and pigments. And I'm already getting some nice effects. And again some white base tint, Stone Coat. I still have a promo code of Stone Coat, so keep that in mind. You can get $10 off of your $100 order if you use my promo code. It's Petra2019. That's the nice True Aluminum Gold Alloy pigment from Dipon.de. And again, I'm going to swipe. Yeah, and the resin, the consistency is almost the same as the Stone Coat Art Coat. But yeah, I need to see if these effects will stay during drying. And also when it's dry, how the finish is. Because I like that a lot of the Stone Coat Art Coat. But for now the effects stay, and that's good. Again, the nice gold pigment. Yeah, and I wanted to see how this gold was, if it floats on top of or it will sink to the bottom. Because I like it a lot if it stays on top of the resin. And I painted my MDF board a blue color because I want to create a depth that way that you can see that color through the cells or the lacing. I'm also testing different swipe papers. This is Yupo paper, but the first swipes I did was freezer paper, so that's a lot thinner than Yupo paper. So I want to see what I like the most and what the difference is. And for this painting I want some negative space so that the blue color is shown. I think that looks nice. And the Yupo paper you can use again if you clean it with a little bit of alcohol. Then you can use it again. You don't have to throw it away. And I also want to thank my monthly sponsors, Evelyn. Thank you so much for sending me all those nice supplies. And also Dolores and Lori, thank you so much for supporting me so much. So I'm very grateful that you do that each month. So thanks a lot for that. Again, the nice gold. And some electric blue by Lares on top of it. And again the white paste tint next to it. And then I'm going to swipe those colors over the white paste tint. There you can see it, very slowly, not too much pressure on the resin. And it looks like the gold is staying on top. So that's good. I only need to see if it also stays on top during drying. And so far the resin is great. The effects stay. So this resin is not available yet, because I'm still testing it. As soon as it is available, then I will mention it in one of my videos. Some heat to remove already some air bubbles, not too much heat, because then the resin gets too thin and your effects will go away. Yeah, I didn't like that swipe, so I'm going to do another swipe in this area. So first the white base tint, because I want some lacing there. Then the nice Antius Color Shift Pearl Pigment from Dipon, the German company. All the materials I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box, with all the links to the websites, so also the links to the pigment. And then again I'm going to swipe. And the torch for the air bubbles, and I got some nice effects. I hope they stay during drying, because it looks great. Also the gold lays on top, so I hope it stays on top, but we will see. Looking at the design, if I need to change something, but I'm very pleased how it looks. So I will let this dry, and after it's dry I will show you all a close-up. So this is how it looks after drying, and the effects stayed, so that's great, because then the consistency of the resin is good, and also the gold stayed on top. Very nice, also some nice lacing and great depth because of the color of the MDF board. And I must say, the finish is great. It's also just like glass, but I want to test this resin more with other effects and also other techniques. There you can see the nice lacing. Very nice. Also the pigments of Dipon.de, the gold and the Antius color shift is very nice. It sparkles a lot, so I'm very pleased with my tests and experiments. I want to test it some more. I will show you all in another video then. But for now I want to thank you all for watching, and if you like my tutorials, please consider subscribing to my channel. I would appreciate it a lot. And also give me a thumbs up for this video if you like what I'm doing. All the links to the materials are in the description box. Also to my Facebook and Instagram page. I normally post every day a message. So thanks again to all my sponsors. There I'm showing you that the gold is laying on top. Very nice. It's just like gold leaf. So I was just saying thank you so much for my sponsors. It helps me a little bit with buying the supplies I need to make these tutorials. So thanks a lot for that. And again, thank you for watching my videos. I appreciate it a lot. And I will see you all in the next video. Bye.